What's up video, welcome to another video, and today's video will be regarding the Apple new iPhone SE. Apple has just unveiled the new iPhone SE, sticking with the rumor date even if there was no flashy online event, just a press release. Despite what its name might have you believe, the new iPhone SE is more of the refresh of iPhone 8 than of the original SE. You can think it as an iPhone 8 with the latest chipset and a better camera, and you wouldn't be losing out on particular anything. Oh, there is a new color option for you guys in that particular device. The new iPhone SE has a 4.7 inch of a screen surrounded by large bezels, and it uses a touch ID fingerprint sensor like the iPhone 8, powered by the A13 SoC just like the iPhone 11, 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max. Its camera has benefited from the new chipset. You get a 12 megapixel sensor now on the backside of the device with a dual pixel autofocus, but it doesn't features improved smart HDR photography. But hey, thanks to the raw power inside the chip for portrait shot, you will get a secondary camera sensor. Apple has gone with something called monocular depth sensing, which uses a machine learning to detect the depth and faces. We all see that how it compares with the first three Google Pixel generation in terms of quality of portrait mode shot from one lens. The camera has the optical image stabilization and cinematic stabilization works on video, which can record up to 4K 60 frames per second. The front-facing selfie cam is still a 7 megapixel unit, and it has some portrait mode effects too. Otherwise, this is an iPhone 8. It even ships with the same massive 5 watt of charger in the box. However, the new iPhone SE does support 18 watt of fast charging. You just need to buy another adapter. The iPhone SE 2020 also supports a wireless charging, Wi-Fi 6, LTE and dual SIMs. Although the second SIM is going to be an eSIM, gone is the 3D touch tech, now replaced with the haptic touch. The new iPhone SE has gone a lot in the size compared to the original model, but again the phone has been doing that left and right in the past few years, so it may just qualify as the compact device in this day and age, depending on what exact definition of that may be. The 2020 iPhone goes on pre-order this Friday on April 17 and will start shipping on April 24. In the US. You can get one for $399 with 64GB of internal storage, so price wise at least it does fit in chosen name. But if you need higher storage, you can get 128GB of internal storage iPhone SE 2020, and it will cost you around $449. While the 256GB of internal storage can cost you around $549. So overall, that particular device is going to be a mid-old variant of iPhone 8 with the latest chipset inside it, and it is for those people who are really wanting to upgrade from the iPhone 6 or 7 to a new improved chipset. So price-wise, this device is going to be one of the massive hit in underdeveloping countries, just like in India, or you can say in the rest of the world, where the other iPhone models are so much on a higher price. So guys, that is it in this particular video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, what you think about that particular device which Apple has just announced, and I'll meet you in the next one. Peace out.